My son recently, Damien, went to New York. He wanted to celebrate the New York Giants football game with his New York friends, but also he took images of the train. That's where we used to stand waiting to get the train to go to Manhattan, the Bronx, to visit people. There's a lot of memories that pop up when he took these images. I mean, this is the backyard of our tenement apartment building where he lived, and in fact, he used to run around with his friends and go in and out. I mean, they would just chase each other and you could hear them having a lot of fun. There's another story about this, which I think he will be embarrassed for me to say, but one time he inadvertently threw the cat out the window, but the cat didn't get hurt. In fact, the cat came back pregnant and had two kittens. So it was a funny story. Maybe someday I'll tell you. But yeah, so when I look at this, you know, it's probably the way it was looking before, but it looked kind of like, ew, like scary, kind of dirty and stuff like that. And maybe it is, maybe it's not. It's, you know, how you remember things back in the day. So he took a lot of these images, and I when I look at them, I think of him going through the alleyway and shouting from the alleyway to my apartment, to the back of my, you know, the window, shouting, "Hey, Mom, can I go here? Can I go there? Can I have some money? Blah, blah, blah." So yeah, he took a lot of these images, which brings back, you know, a lot of memories. This part was an old abandoned lot, and the people from the building actually got together and started planting, and I think they did a good job. They got tomatoes, corn, lettuce, and stuff like that. So it was good use of an abandoned lot. That's kind of the back of the lot, and that's the Brooklyn Expressway, I believe it is. I forgot. But the cars would go up there going towards Queens and stuff like that. And then underneath, a little ways down underneath, they would, it was not too safe to go. In fact, Steven Seagal made some movies under this highway. And back in the day, there was a lot of prostitutes that hang around in some parts of underneath the highway, but I think it's been cleaned up. You know, things happen. And this is where my mother lived. She lived on the second floor, windows facing to the front, because she always liked to look out the window, which was kind of neat, in the grocery store downstairs. She used to just sit out the window, smoke her cigarette, and enjoy the view. Fourth Avenue, where we lived, was the big street where the New York Marathon comes through, and it's a sight to behold. I mean, you hear almost the thumping of the people running, and you see the helicopters hovering over the in the sky, waiting for the people to come up, you know, approach us. And everybody was on the fire escape down by the street with cups waiting to give to the marathon runners. I mean, it was such a delight. I mean, everybody really got together, and I think that's what New Yorkers do. They get together, they celebrate. And my son, when he went to New York and the New York Giants won, I mean, he has a video on YouTube that just blew me away. That togetherness was just awesome. And in that window, Larson's windows and doors, my ex-husband used to work there, because the landlord was also the owner of Larson. So I'm thinking he doesn't live there anymore. I mean, he's probably not working there. Probably his sons took over. And that little street, which is a little blurry, but that's okay. It's going towards Fort Hamilton Parkway. My son would walk with his friends and take the bike, which I didn't know. He didn't tell me that he did, but anyway, you know, kids. So he would walk along this street. It's still Fourth Avenue. Then he would at some point cut across the street to towards Fort Hamilton Park and Parkway. I don't remember this church really. I think it's on Fourth, but a little bit lower, farther away from us. I think that was a church. It looks familiar, but that tall building in the background, I don't think it was there when we lived there. So he goes on his way towards the park, and he's just documenting every, it's like if he's documenting his footsteps, you know, the path that he took with his friends, and just documented from memory and enjoyed it. And this is another park. I mean, it's still on his way, but so he just, you know, him and his friends, I think he had 4 or 5 buddies that they really grew up together. Unfortunately, when we moved, he didn't really have contact with them anymore, so we don't really know what happened. This was underneath one of the Fourth Avenue, because that highway, those cars are heading towards the Fort Hamilton Parkway, which runs along the East River, I guess. And goes up towards Coney Island. This park, I gotta say, my son and my other son and my cousin, we were in the park. They were playing softball or baseball. Anyway, he was little, and my cousin, I remember her shouting when he hit the ball. She said, Damien, run home, run home, run home. And Damien just kept running. He was fast. He ran and ran. But the only thing was that he ran out of the park because she was saying run home. So I know he doesn't want me to say this, but he was a little boy, you know, he didn't know. So, but I thought that was really cute. Another part, I think this is getting towards more close to the parkway. I might be wrong, he was busy taking photographs and every little thing. He said he was feeling kind of funny because people thought, what is he taking all these photographs for? But it's, you know, part of your history and everything. This is a beautiful shot of where the freighters would go close to the pier. And it's like a little hill that you could look down and see the bay, East River. The cars going towards Coney Island or going into Manhattan. And it's called the American Veterans Memorial Pier. I don't think it was called that when we lived there. I'm not sure what it was called, but so it brings back a lot of memories for myself as well. Because we used to have a picnic, we'd take your stuff over, we'd walk it, you know, as we were tiring. But that's a view of the pier. And people still fish there, and it's just a nice getaway, and a little bit close to that, like I said, you could do a picnic basket. I think about it, and it's just so beautiful. They put more benches and tables, so I guess people can just have a picnic like we used to. There wasn't no tables at the time, they just had some benches, but I'm glad they put those, and they have lights, so if you want to go at night, that's cool. And that's the Verrazano Bridge, which connects, is that Staten Island, to Brooklyn. And we travel a lot on that bridge when I used to live in Pennsylvania. We'd come visit in Brooklyn and go over that bridge, very big bridge. And this is the fire escape from back to where I used to live, back home. We used to sit at the fire escape, especially during 4th of July. I mean, people would be just throwing things all over the place. It was kind of a neat thing to see. And after it was all done, there was the smoke of the firecrackers and everything. Yeah, thank you, Damien, for sharing these photographs. And it brings back a lot of memories. Love you. And take care, everyone. Bye-bye. Thank you.